Hello, my name is Lakshya Bansal and I am an MBA student of Department of Management Studies, IIT Roorkee. Now, I am going to briefly explain how AHP works with the help of Excel. So, as we all know, AHP is a multi-criterion decision-making tool which is used as a tool to select the best project among the portfolio. So, there can be multiple factors to judge a project, but for illustration purpose, we have used four factors, which are like quality, price, service and delivery. So as we can see in this matrix, every factor is related with respect to other factors in terms of their relative importance. So here we are seeing a matrix and we have some numbers. So the significance of these numbers is the importance of one factor over the other factors. So like here two, what its significance is, quality is twice as important as price. Similarly, quality is four times as important as services, and here like services is twice as important as delivery. So what our next step is to find the relative significance of quality and price. Like we know quality is twice important as price, so price is half importance as quality. So if we are just selecting it, then what it says, the price is half importance as quality. Similarly, service is 0.25 importance as quality. Why? Because quality is 4 times of service. So what its significance is, service is 1 by 4 times of quality. So after filling this, what we comes to know that sum of we have to find the sum. So here quality significance is 2.1 plus 0.5 plus 0.25 plus 0.33, and the total will be 2.083. Similarly, we will add all these values sum. So we have used the sum function for this. So after finding the sum, what our next step is to normalize these values, because we have to find the weightage of each factor. So we have to normalize first. So for normalize, what the procedure we are doing is dividing this value with the sum. So it will constitute between 0 and 1 only. So 1 divided by 2.083, it will become 0.48. Similarly, 0.5 upon 2.083 is equals to 0.24. So as we can see here, B21 divided by B24, so it will be 0.24. similarly, we do it for every factor, and after that we figure out the average of all these values. So average, what its significance is, the weightage of quality over all the these factors. So quality is 0.45, similarly price is 0.29, and once we add all these factors, what we get, the 1. So the sum should be equals to the 1. So after this, what our next step is to move to the project values. So now we have taken the values of project with respect to other project and with respect to the quality. Like P1 and P1 with respect to quality have equal factors, so value is 1. But P1 has 5 times important as P2 with respect to quality. So value is 5, like we have done earlier. Similarly, P1 is 6 times as important as P3 with respect to quality. So again, what our next step is, like same only, to fill this empty cells. So P2 is 0.2 times as important as P1, or we can say it is 1 by 5 times as important as P1. Similarly, P3 is 1 by 6 as important as P1. And for this P4 is 3 times as important as P1. Why? Because P1 is only 0.3 times important as P4. So here value can be fractions and simple integers also. So our next step is again to add all these value. So we will figure out the sum of this. Similarly, P2 sum plus this. So you can see we have used the sum function. Now, as you all can recall, what our next step is? Yeah, you guess it correctly. We have to normalize this value. So 1 divided by 4.36 will be P1 with respect to P1. So 0.2290. Similarly, 0.2 divided by 4.36 is 0.04, and we fill out all the empty cells. Now we have to calculate again average. So average of this value will be this. So it is as the weightage of these factors. So again, what we will see, the sum of average should always be equals to the 1. So it should be 1. So if you have done all this correct, if you have get the value of 1, then means you have done the process correctly. So So after doing this, we will do the same steps with respect to the price. So we have done the same. So what we are getting, the factors like average is this. So weighted average of P1, P2, and again sum we are getting 1. Now with respect to service, again average is 1. And last is with respect to delivery. So we have got the average of all the project P1, P2 with respect to quality, with respect to price, with respect to service, with respect to delivery. So here what we can see, like average is 0.15 with respect to delivery P1. So P1 is 0.15. Now 0.059 is P2 with respect to delivery. So delivery is 0.059. Similarly, 0.63817 and 0.1509. And we can see here the value is like N114 and 114. So, and again, next is N115. After doing this, and these weightages are the quality weight that we have find it here, 0.45, 0.29, 0.13. So we got the weightage of quality, price, service delivery itself. And with the weightage of quality in project P1, P2, P3, P4. Now our next step is to multiply the weights of P1 with quality. So what we get, 0.29 into 0.45 is 0.135. Again, similarly P2 with respect to quality, with similarly P3 and similarly P4. Now we will do the P1 with multiply to price. So we got this value. So it will be like B124 is this one into C124. C124 into B124. So we get these values. So now what we have got, P1 with respect to quality, price, service, delivery. So we will add all these value. What we get is 0.324578. Similarly, we will add P2, P3, P4. So we have used the sum function M1232, M126. Similarly, L1232, L126. Now this determines the best project and the worst project. So how can we determine, like the maximum value is the worst project and the minimum value in this is worst project. So what we are getting is 0.32457 is as the best project. So P1 is the best project. So if we click it, what we are getting, P1. Similarly for worst project, it is 0.14. So P3 is the worst project. And if we are seeing the function that we have used, so we have used the address and then the indirect function to find out this value. So if you see just what the function address and indirect do, then you can also figure out the value, like minimum value across all this minimum. And we have calculated the same project value from this. So this minimum function will help to determine the minimum of this. This address will help to determine the address value, like L126. And now this indirect function will help to add find the value of P3. So this is all about AHP, but now we will find out the limitations of this AHP and how can we come out with that limitation in the further videos. Here in AHP, values like 2, 4, 3 and something like this, we have used the SETI scale. For example, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. We have exact one value for comparing two factors. But in real life, since the uncertainty and vagueness of experts' opinion is the prominent characteristics of the problem, this impreciseness of humans' judgment can be handled through the fuzzy set theory. So instead of using single one, we are using a triangular scale. So value is like 1, 1, 1. So instead of using only value 3, we are calculating the value of the best project using the triangular scale of 2, 3, 4. So for weakly important, we are using 2, 3, 4. Similarly, for fairly important, we are using 5 as on a SETI scale. But here for the triangular scale, we are using the value 4, 5, 6. Similarly, for the absolutely important, we are using the SETI scale as 9. But here in triangular scale, I am using the value as 9, 9, 9. So now how to use this value in the fuzzy AHP, that's I will explain you in the fuzzy AHP problem. Similarly, like we have taken four factors there, AHP, quality, price, service and delivery. Here we are taking five factors: quality, origin, cost, delivery, and after sales. So here, like, quality is equally important to quality, so we have used the value 111. Similarly, if we are saying quality and origins are also equally important, so we are saying 111. But quality is fairly important than cost, we are saying the value 456. But here, like delivery and the cost, what we are saying, cost is only 0.25 importance at delivery, similarly 0.33 times, and it is like 0.5 times. So we knows all these values by different factors now, but and now we have to fulfill these metrics also. So our step one will constitute the same value, like origin is the opposite of this, and the cost is like 1 divided by 4, which is 0.25. the most important is in this set is that we have to write the values in the increasing order only. So if we are writing like 1 by 4 1 by 5 1 by 6, we will find that 1 by 6 has the lowest value and 1 by 4 has the greatest value than 1 by 6. So we have to reverse this value. So cost is like 1 by 6 times of this value, 1 by 5 is 0.2 and 1 by 4 is 0.25. similarly for delivery, what we are saying, 1 by 8 here, 1 by 7 here, 1 by 6 here. How can we do that in Excel is like we can take out the maximum value across these values. If we are checking 4 5 6, we are taking the maximum value and divided by 1. For 2, we are taking like median value because it will be the median of this, and for 3 it is like the minimum of this value, so it will come out 4, and 1 by 4 will be my value. Similarly, we have done this for everything. Now, as we have said that cost and delivery is like delivery is 0.25, 0.33 and 0.5. So if we are checking for delivery is 2 times as important as cost, 2, 3, 4 means weakly important as with respect to the cost. After doing this, our next step as here is different from the AHP. Here we will take the geometric mean. So geometric means way of quality is like geometric mean of the value of all factors with respect to the quality. So here we are using the formula geo mean to calculate the geometric mean, and the first value will be the first values of all the factor with respect to quality. So geometric mean of B13 means quality, first value, E13, H13, K13 and N13. So first value of all the factors and taking geometric mean is my quality geometric mean of the first cell. Similarly, second cell geometric mean is like 1 1 5 7 5, and geometric mean of this value will be my geometric mean of second factor. So similarly, we will do this for all the values. Like after sales, we will calculate the geometric mean. After that, our next step is to sum all the values. So sum value will be like summing of all these values of all the factors. Similarly, we will sum these values, and similarly we will sum all these values. Now we will inverse the value. So 1 upon B29, like 1 upon B29 is my inverse value. After inversing, we have to reverse the value, or we can say we have to write in the increasing order. So 0.12 is the minimum, 0.13 is the maximum, and 0.15 is the minimum maximum. So similarly, we use the minimum function, we use the median function, and we use the maximum function to write all these factors. Now next step is to multiply this value with this value. So it will be like multiplying B24 with B31. So what we are doing actually, we are just multiplying the quality value with respect to the all the values. So it is like we are doing normalizing in that case. Similarly, here we are doing 2.49 to 0.12 and we are getting 0.3038. similarly, 2.8 with 0.139 will give me 0.384. similarly, we have done for like 2.7 with 0.12 will give me 0.32. So now we have filled all these values. Now our next step is to calculate the average of those values. So here we taken out the average of like these three values, and we can say this is the weight, but I will not say this is the weight. Why? I will explain you later. Similarly, in origin, it will be 0.41. In cost, it will come out average at 0.07. Now, if we add it, we will find that the value is not equals to 1. Means we have to again normalize these values. So what step we have taken in AHP? We have divided this value by the total value. So we get 0.39 but divided by 1.01, we are getting 0.38. Similarly, 0.41 divided by 1.01, we will get 0.40. Now if we will sum it, I will get a value 1. That means we can say these are the normalized value, and we can say these are the weighted values of all these factors. After this, we will go to the project part. Now here we have written down all the values with in the project with respect to quality. So here we can say quality is equally important in project 1 and project 2 as the value is 1. But quality in project 1 is weakly important than the quality in project 3. Similarly, quality in project 4 is important than the quality in project 3, or where we can say quality in project 3 is less important than quality in project 4. Now our next step is to fill these values, all the empty blank cells. So once we did this, we will figure out these values. Here what we have to do, we have to take reciprocal, but we have to arrange it in the increasing order only. So here 1 by 4 is equal to 0.25, so it will come first. 1 by 3 is 0.333, so second column, and 1 by 2 is 0.5. What we have seen at every place, that value is going in increasing order only, like 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6. So here also it should be the follow the same pattern. So to like 2, 3, 4, in this 4 is greater than 2, but if we are taking inverse, then 1 by 4 is less than 1 by 2. That's why we are making it here reverse. After this, we have to calculate the geometric mean. For geometric mean, what we are doing, we are taking the first value of every project with respect to other projects. Like for P1, 1 into 1 into 2 into 6 into 4, and we have to take the geometric mean with the formula geo mean. After this, we will get a value 2.16. Similarly, for 2.53, it is like geometric mean of second place, 1, 1, 3, 7, 5, and geo mean of these values. Similarly, we do it for every project. Now we will take the total of this project, then we will do the inverse, and then arrange it in the increasing order. So for increasing, we can use like minimum function, then median function here, and then maximum function, so that it get arranged in the increasing order. Now our next step is to get multiply this and 2.16 with the increasing order value 0.12. So what we get, 2.74104. So it is the multiplication of these values. Similarly, if we have to multiply this project 3, so project 3 middle value with the median value of this increasing order. So we get these value. After this, we will take the average of every project. So this, we are using average function to take the average of first three columns. Similarly, we are taking average of these things. After average, we will take out the sum. As sum is not equals to 1, so we have to normalize it. So how to normalize? 0.3739 divided by 1.02, that will make us 0.36. Similarly, we do it for every field, and then when we sum it will comes to 1. Similarly, we have done this for with respect to origin, same steps, and taking out the weighted of the project 1, project 2 with respect to origin. Now with respect to cost, same what we are doing. Similarly, with respect to delivery. And finally, with respect to after sales. After sales means services that we are providing. Now, we got the weights of the quality, origin, cost, delivery, after sales from the first three steps. So here are the weights of the quality, origin, cost, delivery, and after sales. As we can see, 0.38294. 0.3894. So we wrote down all the weights. Now, like here, what it is the for the after sales. So after sales is like for project one, after sales value is 0.461757. For project two, it is 0.297554. Similarly, 0.077, 0.09, and 0.073. Similarly, we did for every of all the project with respect to every factors. Now our next step is to multiply weight with the project. So 0.38294 into 0.364. That will make us P1 with respect to quality 0.1392. Similarly, we do it for every project. What we can see here, B213 into C213. That will give us the value. After this, similarly, like we have done in AHP, we will take out the sum of all these values. Now, which project is best among here? It is project one. Why? Because it is having the greatest sum value. And which is the least project? Your worst project, what we can say? It will be 0.06 P4. So now we will check what is our project. Best project is P1 and worst project is P4. Again, we have used the same formula. First, we will found the minimum value. Then we will use the address to find the address of that value. And then using indirect, we will figure out P2 value from this. So this is all from my side. Hope it will helps you to find the which project is important in AHP with respect to AHP and with respect to fuzzy AHP.